What is up, heroes? This is Midnight Zero, and welcome back to Let's Play Soma Blind. In the last episode, we attempted to take the Dunbat, but that didn't go so hot. So our backup plan is we're going to go to Omicron and take an elevator down. But first, Catherine was hoping to learn a little bit more about how the Ark works, so we were going to try to do that while we're here. Anything new in the documents here? I don't know if this is actually new or not, but regardless, my decision. I've decided to finalize the Ark with the scans we have. I'm sorry for all of you who wanted to go but didn't get a chance to scan yourself before the project was put on hold. It's been 2 months since I've added a scan, and I don't see how I'll ever be able to win back the support you all showed me when we started the project. I'm sorry. I never meant for anyone to take their lives. It was never my intention to fool anyone. I just wanted to save something. What's left? Apply interface module, seal Ark capsule, ask permission from 4Q, Brief, Ivashkin, Lindwall, Peterson, and Hill, take shuttle to Omicron. Take shuttle to Omicron, pick up power suits, ride the climber into the abyss, regroup at Tau, head to launch site, load the bullet, launch the Ark. Interesting. So this tells us how they got it down, right? They used the climber from Omicron, and they were going to regroup at Tau. If the Ark is still in the abyss, though, it never got launched from that bullet. What do we have over here?
That's Phi, all right. Quick stop at Omicron, then Tau, then Phi.
Let's do it.
Okay, Omicron, then Tau, then Phi. So shuttle to Omicron, then change to HPS, ride the climber into the abyss. That's from Omicron. And then check on Tau. Anyone alive? It's interesting that this was written at that time period. So whatever was going on in the world at the moment made it such that whoever was drawing this diagram, arguably, or probably Catherine, even questioned whether or not anybody was alive at Tau. Huh. Okay. I wonder if those codes on the left are worth remembering. Probably not, but who knows. And then it says, prep Ark with signal transmitter, power packs, tools, extra oxygen, pole permission. Wonder if that'll be useful information. Anything over here? No. What about this here? Ah, yes, more Allen wrenches. Just what we needed. Now we've got this here.
The Ark doesn't even look that bulky. This is going to be easy.
You haven't heard of the concept of...
Sorry, I forgot your people were...
That's hilarious. Interesting that she says it like your people, right? I mean, they are from, you know, 100 years or so apart. Can I hit these switches here? No? Okay. I guess the question is, what else are we trying to do at the moment?
What's this?
That's just a compound examiner. Coster uses it to investigate structural integrity in payload frameworks.
Of course.
Could you get inside it? If I knew what you were made of, it would be a hell of a lot easier to figure out how...
I knew that was going to be the follow-up.
I'll give it a try.
How odd is it to have such a detailed analysis of yourself?
Bit of a... tight fit.
Can you reach the on switch?
It's right in front of me, so I guess so.
Should I be worried about radiation?
I think we're beyond that. Interesting. You seem to be one with the diving suit you're wearing. Everything's meshed together.
How's that gonna work with the suit we're picking up at Omicron?
I think they're bigger. You should be able to wear them both.
Imaging. Who's that?
It looks like the basis for your body is one of my old colleagues. A standard cortex chip for robots, including the data reader and the ocutorch, has just been forced through the skull.
What?
Structure gel has fused the whole construction together. Amazing stuff.
No. Hold on. Back up. I'm one of your old colleagues?
Well, your body is. Imogen Reed.
That's disgusting.
Hey, don't say that. She was my... She was nice to me. Anyway... The Cortex chip is good news. That means we can transfer your mind to the Ark with a pilot seat.
Kath, I'm half a dead person.
Yes, it makes sense. Think about it. All those simplistic minds we've run into? Just reviving a dead person doesn't seem to work that well. A robot body seems to make people a bit unreliable. You are the best of both worlds. A sound mind and a sound body.
That's so weird. So we're half...
At least we know
dead person.
Sort of. I understand the concept, but I don't know the specifics. I really wish we could figure out how the scan data is formulated and processed.
So, just are we like actual half-dead body of Imogen Reed? Or is it that we're like a model body based off of Imogen Reed? And if so, it's like it's a human-esque machine body such that when a human's mind is imported to it, it's a little bit more cohesive. And then, of course, given it is still machinery, and now that we have this machine, like, suit on, because of the structure gel we fuse with that, which fits with the picture of what we've seen elsewhere, right? Where people, machines, are all kind of form this conglomerate mess because of, presumably, WoW and the structure gel, right? Like over here. Alright, is there anything else? What else to do? So now Catherine knows what we are made of. It says no device connected. What are we supposed to connect to it is the question. Oh, something over here. What can we put in here? Arc build number 34,124. Compiled Catherine Chan. Theta. Approximately 896 terabyte memory corrupted. Simulation reconfiguration necessary. Yikes. So, most of the system... memory corruption today. Please reduce memory footprint. Interesting. So we're going to have to remove things from the arc, essentially, right? So I don't know if we'll get rid of any of the physics. But we can get rid of, like, this boat, I guess. And... I don't know, what else do we want to get rid of? Interesting, oh my goodness, I bet when we get to the end of the game, we're going to have the chance to go in the arc and it's going to be impacted by this. Soma. Package Soma Human. Is Soma like a term used for the humans once they're in the arc? Interesting. Alright, well, what else do we want to get rid of? I guess we can get rid of... I don't want to get rid of all this. I guess we can get rid of the dirt road. And we can get rid of heat. Oh, some of them require certain ones. Alright, we're going to have to get rid of a lot anyways. Alright, so we'll keep heat, but we'll get rid of the foliage and the lake and the chair and the river. Oh, so the Soma requires water. We can get rid of... buoy. Interesting. So this is actually a little bit of a puzzle where certain things are required by certain other things. Oh, so we need some sort of light. What is this? So the river and moon require the fluid physics. What about soft? I guess this works. We have 90 terabytes to add. Do we want to add anything back is the question. Let's add back some foliage. And hope for the best from here, right? Is there anything else we can add? I guess we can add this basic veg basic. This is such an interesting concept.
I'm running a dummy scan. Shouldn't be that difficult. I just want to make sure I understand how the scan data is formulated before we start messing around with the real art.
Oh.
Run the simulation and then hit pause while the code is running. It'll give me a cross-section of the process.
I want to use Simon.
Better not use real data. I don't want to repeat what we did to Brandon.
Okay.
Second that.
Dummy data it is. Okay. Might as well start the simulation. Interesting. The world time is passing with a particular amount. And it looks like, I mean, all the modules should have loaded at this point.
We need to pause while the dummy is loaded, otherwise I can't know if it's working or not.
Okay. How long will it take for the dummy to get loaded?
Try pausing it when the dummy is loaded. You need to catch it while it's being loaded.
If I lower the resource allocation, it'll probably slow it down. There we go. Nice.
Yes, of course. So precise, so perfect.
Nothing like admiring your
own
work.
What? Oh, right.
That's actually really funny.
Are we done here? Can we go to Omicron and get my new suit now?
Yeah, we should get going.
Want to bring this arc as a backup?
No, that wouldn't work. This is just a prototype.
Good. I prefer to travel light.
Let's go. Don't forget to take me with you.
The question is, where did I put you? Over here? Okay. Catherine obtained and ready to rock and roll. Do we want to go this way or do we want to go this way? So we can use our Omni-tool there. We cannot use our Omni-tool here. So there wasn't even a choice in the first place. This game's environment kind of reminds me of Dead Space. I played the first, like, half hour of that at some point, got distracted by something else before going back to it. But I've been wanting to play that again for quite some time. Would you guys be interested in that too? I feel like those of you who are interested in Soma would be interested in Dead Space. Granted, Soma seems to be really exploring some deep themes, some meta themes, more so than just creating a horror experience, you know? So I'd imagine a lot of the fans of Soma aren't even necessarily huge horror fans, as much as they are fans of games that explore really complex themes and do so in very creative ways. What's over here? System error. Okay, so we can't go over this way. So I guess we can start heading off in this direction. What does this say? No foreign contaminants beyond this point. Oh. Well, you certainly have seen better days. Excuse me? Did you hear that? What in the world was that sound? And then the other question is, oh man, these are always so tough to look at. You can like hear this one wheezing, this one crying. The other question is there a monster out there waiting for us? I don't know. It kind of sounded like it. I don't know if this is like a collectible in addition to being a sort of like health replenisher. I know if it's strictly a health replenisher, we just wasted it. Oh, there is a friend out there. That's for sure. Is he gonna come in here? He is. Oh, we're so screwed. We're so screwed. This is very not good. Wow, we get a close-up look. This one looks a little bit more humanoid than the others. Interesting. I guess if what Catherine was talking about was those sort of humanoid-esque bodies, or at least corpses, mixing with WoW, we might be somewhere on the spectrum of this monster thing, right? A humanoid body? Oh no, don't you dare turn. Don't you dare turn. Ah, crap, we're dead. GG, guys. I'm shocked it only saw me on the way back. And of course, now we've wasted our health refill. Lovely, 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 lovely. Okay. And we are now injured and moving rather slowly, which is not good. So where is our rather violent friend at the moment? Because we are, like, hobbling. Hobbling through this area so slowly. We can go in here for now. Close the door, not that it really does much for us. In fact, it might even attract it. What does this show? Ah, crap. It sounds like it's walking through here. Oh, man. So it says survival of the fittest. Okay. I'm not really sure. Those drawings are certainly not random. I just wonder who they are at the moment. And what we can do in this room. It doesn't seem like a whole lot at the moment. Oh, a data buffer.
Sarah, how the hell are we gonna make
Oops, that's not what I wanted to do.
Sarah, how the hell are we gonna make sure the Ark makes it?
Heavy launch is a crapshoot, you know that.
I just wish these numbers looked better.
What do you care? It's just a pack of data, right?
Yeah, just a pack of data.
Interesting. So there wasn't even a lot of assurance that if the Ark were launched, it would be successful. Alright. So we'll keep creeping along here. Curious to check out this end first. Anything in there? Doesn't look like it. This looks just like a dead end, which is good to know. Still gonna hold off on running for now, because that's quite a bit louder and definitely attracts the enemy AI. Can we go anywhere in this direction? It looks like there's a ramp leading upward, but it's a dead end. However, it is kind of dark. I wonder if how dark or light a particular area is actually impacts the AI's ability to detect us. I don't know. Maybe we'll find out eventually. Okay, we can heal up over here. Or not. It's already been used, I guess. Or it hasn't charged, or something. Either way, looked like it could have been used, but it can't. What's going on in this room? What's that sound? It's like the printer or something? What does this show? Are these different types of launches, or what? Propulsive efficiency? They're playing Hangman. There's like, what? The second one is quantum computing. The last one is Golem. The first one is what, though? I'm like so on edge. What's the first one? For some reason, I keep thinking like Blader, but I don't think that's it. Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe we'll come back to that later. Probably not, though. Plenty of games of tic-tac-toe. I will say I'm surprised for people so smart. I'd be shocked if they actually had genuine fun playing tic-tac-toe. A game that's completely solved, right? Alright, this looks like a little lecture hall of sorts. The question is, what was being shown? These are different instances of probably WoW fusing with people. Notably, look at that left eye, right? That person's left eye had become the same sort of robotic eye that we have. Interesting. So that furthers the idea that the fusion of WoW with a body can take place, and it looks something like that. And we are likely that product. The question is, that I'm still not 100% on is, were they replicated attempts at, I guess, like copies of bodies, or a real body? The game actually makes me think it's the latter. Lovely. I love when lights start to flicker in horror games. You know the fun stuff is gonna happen then. Okay, plenty of blood in here. Always a good sign. Oh, we got static, which is just lovely. So we'll... Oh, I can't hide behind this? Oh no, I can. Okay, great. Because there's a very real chance it walks in this room. Oh my goodness. So I wonder, from an AI standpoint, I wonder if it heard me open the door, and that's why it showed up here and is specifically trying to open the door now. I bet that's the case, actually. How terrifying. But I think we should be safe behind here. Right? Out of sight. Arguably out of reach, too, right? So that's probably it opening the other door on its way out. The static's getting a little bit less strong. The real question, though, is when it walks out the other door, is it going to turn right or left? If it turns right, it's going to come back towards this door. But if it turns left, it's going to get further away. I don't think we'll be able to judge that until I stop talking and listen, or if the static gets a little bit weaker. Pretty tough to tell, honestly. The static has weakened. So I think we're fairly safe for the time being. These look like little containers where there was some experimentation done related to... Wow. Wow, what is going on with all of these experiments? Why is there so much blood? Okay. Some scans, plenty more blood, what looks like an operating room. Oh man, operating rooms in horror games are always rough. What is this?
Terry Akers, Chief Factor at Delta, first assessment. Brought in today, January 16th, 2104. Reportedly found in his diving suit, unconscious.
Yikes. Yikes. Is this a dissection of Terry Akers? Possibly. Wow. So we know he... So this is also confirmation that he was clearly distorted and affected in quite a few different ways. I guess follow the blood. Yikes. Let's check out the computer. Terry Akers, age 66, sex male. One of the worst cases I've seen, and it's most likely his own fault. He blinded himself and clogged up his insides with structure gel. I'd be surprised if he ever woke up from the coma. Did make me think of Hart's absurd story about what happened at Lambda. Could it really be that the WoW is somehow able to change and rebuild the H? Never? Okay. And then Vanessa Hart. Hart appears to be in good shape considering the circumstances. Only bruises and mild hypothermia caused by the long walk. It's difficult to corroborate her story as she is the only one to return. Catherine Chun. Huh. As usual, Chun is quiet and does her best to avoid eye contact. She doesn't want to be here, but Strohmeyer demands another evaluation. Chun isn't obstinate or dishonest, but she'd rather not speak if it can be avoided. She has a hard time dealing with people in general, including doctors. Catherine Chun is weak in character, the perfect victim to be domineered and pushed around by others. She is a scared mouse I don't want to upset, so we sit quiet and pass the time. Aw, that's sad. And then Conrad. Conrad is dead. He boiled his brain to pulp with a WREM. Following the ARC neuroscan. Clearly another continuity enthusiast killing himself to take his place on the ARC. So this is some sort of maybe psychiatric evaluation. But, wow. So it's interesting, what happened at Lambda and the story that Vanessa Hart mentioned about it. And then, oh man, this poor person. Okay, where to next? That's my next concern, is I don't really know where to go from here. Lovely, lights flickering. So I think we've been here before. Yes, this is where we started. So the next question is, where do we need to go? And the answer is, I have no idea. I don't think we can go anywhere over here. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, so that looks like an important door. And it looks like one we can use our Omni tool with. So let's see what we can do here. Security error, insert connector chip. What? Let me interact.
Something's missing.
Stromer!
Brad, where are you?
It got out of hand. I'm in sector RD4. Did you get everyone downstairs?
Yeah, we're safe for now. But you need to get moving. They're gonna figure out where we are and come for us.
Don't worry about it. The stairs are blocked and I killed the elevator. Pull the connector chip from the lock.
Fine! That means you're stuck as well!
Only way to keep you guys safe. Take the shuttle, go to Omicron. Good luck, sir.
And
tell Alice I love her.
Dang. So that's how Brandon died. That really sucks. Especially knowing what we did to him during those simulations. Without knowing what essentially became of him. So, there are a couple things to consider at the moment, right? Let's think for a moment. So, there's this elevator we need to access the connector chip for, so we need to find the connector chip somewhere in here. We obviously haven't found it while looking around. Our friend is getting awfully close to us. I don't think I've done anything to tip him off, though, that we're in this room, so hopefully he doesn't come in here. We'll find out soon enough. But also, whatever was going on at Theta, where we are now, it was some takeover by these machines. I'd imagine it was a combination of machines that had, you know, these human scans that WoW had stolen, uploaded to them, and sort of humans combined with machines via structure gel that WoW then integrated with. I would imagine it's some combination of those two that became the, you know, threatening force that people were trying to escape from. All these sounds are so unsettling. Alright, well, I guess we'll take another lap around and see what we can find. Remember, all of these were not helpful. So I guess we can take a look in here again. I don't think we heard in that data buffer where the lock was hidden, did we? So I don't think we got much direction on where to go, just that it's hidden somewhere. Then I think this was the lecture hall, right? Yep. I don't see it here. Did I go in here? Yeah, I think so. I remember where that is. I think we explored all the rooms, but I don't know. Did we check out this one in the back corner? Maybe not, actually. Okay. So, if previous instances are anything to go off of, that may trigger the robot to come in here. Not the robot, but our machine friend. Well, machine, part human, part AI, who knows, right?
Strohmeyer, you there?
I hear you, Brandon. What do you got?
Akers and his critters are ferocious. They pick up on every move. There's no way past them.
Then we'll fight them. We got to get to the shuttle.
And end up like Shank and Adams? No way. Listen, I'll create a distraction and pull them to me. Get the gang to the shuttle station.
Wait, Brandon, what are you doing?
Don't worry, Alice. I'll loop back as soon as you guys are safe.
Just load up the shuttle and be ready to go.
Are you sure about this?
I don't plan to die today, sir. See you at the shuttle.
Oof, we know how that turned out. But it is also interesting to know that that's how things progressed. So, Project Development Hub, let's see here. The main lift, security checkpoint, archive. I think we are in the security checkpoint at the moment. Where have we not gone to? The restrooms? Or the maintenance area, I don't think. But we've been to most other rooms. Let's see what's on this computer here. Override door lock. Oh, interesting. So this is unlocked. That's unlocked. There were a couple rooms that were locked, though, right? System malfunction, lock limits active. Remaining resources, zero. Oh, I see. So how many rooms are actually currently locked? Only a few, right? So I guess we can lock off the conference room for now, and that'll allow us to unlock Omega Management. And that's going to be close to where we started. And so if we go to Omega Management, we'll probably find the connector chip there. And I think that's what Brandon had been referring to when he said that he locked it. Key control, no chip inserted, security messages, alert dispatch. Huge structure gel leak has caused the WoW to seize control over the Dunbat, forced to quarantine to avoid further development. Last thing we need is another talking machine. Lovely. All right, so we're about to get bodied. If this thing walks in here, we are totally screwed. Oh, you know what? We just locked the door. So hopefully that keeps us safe. I think it worked, actually. Oh, so I can always lock multiple doors, but I can't unlock a whole bunch of them. Okay. So yeah, we'll lock the conference room for now. And when we get out of here, we're going to turn right and then go straight for a while and then left. Let's see what we can do, guys. Classic flicker, classic. So we gotta go by that green sign there. And then we're going to turn left, and it'll be on our right. Slowly. Oh, don't make noise. Don't make noise, Simon. Okay. It's this door here. Dang. Make more noise, will ya? Who are you? Oh my goodness. You're Brandon. Brandon Wan.
I'm sorry about before, Brandon. I'm sorry we couldn't let you rest in peace.
Also, look at how limp his arm was when we took that from him. That is tough to listen to. What is this? I don't know, but... Uh-oh. Why did it just save? Why did it just save? We have the connector chip now. What's it about to do differently? Oh, boy. I don't like this. Alright, so we can go out and to the left and we should be at the elevator soon. Oh, crap. So I don't have a great place to hide in this room, unfortunately. But I think this is the best we're going to be able to do. So let's hope for the best. Darn, we were so close. Is it in the room? I think so. It shouldn't have seen us walk this far in the room, though, so hopefully it doesn't come all the way up here to Brandon. Uh-oh. It kind of sounds like it's getting closer, and the static's getting more intense. Are we going to be able to hold on? Oh man, it's got to be right by me. It's right around the corner. I mean, all we can do is hold tight. Certainly can't run by it. Come on, leave. Leave. Please. It's moving. And I'm not convinced it's getting any further. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. It's totally getting closer. Oh, but it's on the other side of that. Nice. Is it going to turn around, or is it going to keep going that way? Okay, it's going to keep going that way. So I think we're actually okay. Although, something I always want to keep in the back of my mind is there may be more than one. But at the moment, I think we're okay. However, it's going to turn that corner soon. So we really don't have a lot of time. Come on. Please use the connector. Thank you. Let me do this.
Now what?
Format the chip. What? I have to format the chip? Where do I do that? Key expired. Update chip. Where do I do that? So it's probably not the conference room, is all I can think of. But I don't know. I don't think this is it. Any of this? No? Okay. Didn't think so. I will say, this little segment's probably taking a little bit longer than I'd like. Alright, we'll sneak around this side. Yeah, I thought we'd just be done once we got the connector chip. And I think that would have been kind of nice. We find Brandon, get that story, get the connector chip, and then we're out of here. But now we're kind of stuck wandering around a little bit longer than I would like. This is now our third lap throughout the place. Oh, crap. Seriously? Seriously? The lights are completely out. Oh, man. Can we update it here? Can we format it here? Please? It seems like it. Can I place it on one of these things? There I can. What do these say? Acres is not alone. At least proxy creatures. Check and seal doors, move downstairs, shuttle to Omicron. Actually, hang on one second. Connector chip detected, loading connector chip. We are going to lock ourselves in here for a moment, just while I read this. So what did this say again? So the main thing is, it said to check and seal the doors, and to move downstairs, and that's where we're going to find the shuttle to Omicron. Okay, so that's useful information. What does this say? Name and different position. Okay, Lansky. They're a project manager, but we don't really know. And Strohmeyer was head of security. There it is, walking around there, out there in the dark. Lovely. I wonder if it sees us in here. We are just kind of chilling here. We're not moving, but the door is locked, so hopefully that protects us. Seems like it. Is there any... Hopefully we don't have to remember these names too well. Checklist. Survive the Ark Project. Stop people from killing themselves. Send off C and the team. Keep people safe. Enjoy the rest of Armageddon. Yikes. So my other question is, was this Brandon's checklist or was it Strohmeyer's? I think it's Strohmeyer's, right? Survive the Ark Project and then stop people from killing themselves. Seems like something Strohmeyer was very concerned about. And then send off C and the team. Keep people safe. Enjoy the rest of the Armageddon. So Strohmeyer likely stayed here and died with everybody else here. Okay. So let's go back. Key control. Error key. Expired. Please update. All right. Yeah. So let's update this connector chip. All right, now it is ready for use. Any security messages we need? No, I don't think so. All right, so we're going to take this and honestly take the same route, right? The only problem is it's literally walking where I need to go. Oh, I need to unlock this door again. So let's do that. All right, so we should be clear to walk to the elevator. We just need to make it. Just a little on the dark side. Whoa. Okay, a lot of static. A lot of static. Where is it coming from, though? Where is the static coming from? Did it hear me open the door? It got here. It's not entering the room, though. Where did it go? Okay, so it went back there. It must have seen us from way further down the hall, but I couldn't see it because of how dark it was. Is it gonna turn? It is. Okay, so it's turning left, which will work to our advantage. Oh no, now it's going back down there. Okay, so maybe the plan is instead we take that side pathway and then turn left and go that way. So the door opening probably made some noise, which attracted it. Oh my goodness, it's so dark. So there's some static, which is to be expected. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Keep moving, keep moving. Stay calm. Keep moving. Keep moving. Don't turn this way, please. Don't turn this way, please. Don't turn this way. Okay. Oh, and you can see the blood here, too. That's not good. All right. Please put the connector chip in. Please place the connector chip. I don't know what is going on here. Please. Thank you. So now we have that in place. We have that in place. Please do something. Please. What? Close clamps and panel. Alright, we're going. We're going, we're going, we're going, we're going, we're going. Close the door. We gotta go somewhere. Maintenance. Go, 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 go. Whew. That was really tense. That was really tense, guys. The static building up as we're like trying to get in the elevator. It's like, go, 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 go. I think we probably need to go down to the transport station, right? That's where the shuttle is likely to be. If we're going to try to get to Omicron. But I wonder why then we have the option to go to maintenance in the first place. Huh. It seems like it doesn't matter because we're stuck here in the elevator either way. just lovely. What can we do in here, though? Can we exit the top? What can we do? Is there a hatch? Oh, there's a hatch. Oh, shoot. Oh, shoot. We're gonna have to climb down here. Oh, okay. All right, guys. In the next episode, we're gonna climb down the elevator shaft in the dark. Maybe make it to, I don't know if it'll be the maintenance area or the shuttle area, transport. But either way, we're trying to make our way down to the shuttle so we can get to Omicron. Whew, things have gotten pretty intense. Hope you guys are enjoying them. This was a pretty good episode. I like this quite a bit. I think we spent a little bit too much time wandering around that area, making some laps. But they definitely did a good job with the atmosphere and the spookiness. And I am looking forward to what they do in the future. But until the next episode, this is Moon Knight Zero, and this mission is complete.